What is going on, Gemini? Welcome or welcome back to the channel, Elev8te Spirits. It's Jazi, your favorite Cali reader. So today's reading is going to be your guys's what is being restored, what is spirit restoring in your life at this time, okay? So whenever you see this reading is when it's meant for you. They are timeless as always, unless otherwise specified. As you can see, I'm like, it is that time, okay? Your girl's cycling. And I know that for some, that's TMI. It is what the fuck it is. It's natural, all right? I'm grateful that my body can still cleanse itself in this way, so... So I'm drinking my tea, okay, because we fucking magical, all right, as always. So for those of you that are, I'm just letting you know, so when you see me drinking in between, it's, you know, I'm not being trying to be bougie or whatever, but I really, it helps with my my cramps. So it's a mix for those that can use the mix. It's, I'm drinking hibiscus, red clover, and red raspberry tea. All those are really not only great for your reproductive system, for cramps, but also to clear your skin and for your root chakra. Like, takes care of all of it at once, okay? So, I got my heating pad, okay? Because I needed it and I wanted to, you know, get these readings done, get them out. So I pray that y'all are grateful for me showing up for y'all as you show up here for me as well in this way. Also for yourself, if you're here, you're here for the message, okay? So I'm gonna get into this for you guys. So we are covering what spirit is restoring in general regarding what, like, you know, generally speaking, spiritually speaking, what spirit needs from you to support this restoration process, and in regards to your money, career, finance, business, any of that stuff, okay? So I am gonna look at the bottoms of the decks that I've used as well, and get the hidden message, maybe messages that you're, you know, not seeing, that you may be unaware of, that is maybe not exactly related to this directly. It's, you know, just a little different. It's different messages. So just kind of like hidden information that's not coming up here, basically, okay? So we have retail, eight of swords with the chariot underneath that, two of wands, exchanging gifts, foundation, and decision, fertility, okay? So Geminis, what you may not be seeing that is, some of you may be moving, okay? It's one thing I'm getting here. Some of you may be moving. Some of you may be trying to like establish basically a foundation for yourself, and you may be kind of like unsure about how to do that, what direction to go, what you should invest in. And I feel like for some of you, it may be causing you a bit of stress, okay? But I do feel like it's important for you to kind of do whatever you're being guided to do, maybe share your gifts, okay, with this exchanging gifts. I feel like if you have any type of hidden talents, okay, or skill set that you can offer to the community, that you can offer to the public, I would do that. I feel like it definitely has a potential to yield beautiful results, okay? Otherwise, if you guys, for those of you that have like a gift of, let's say, crafting, right? A gift of making home good, you know, items or, you know, products, things like that, you might really benefit by opening an online store, okay? For those of you that already have one and you maybe haven't, you know, kind of haven't been as enthusiastic about it, maybe kind of lost passion for it, I would try to maybe pick that up again, maybe kind of revamp it, you know, switch your items, do something like that. Just, you know, try something different. Okay. So let's get into this. All right. So with spirit is restoring in general, we have the Magician and the Mirror, card 53. Okay. Card 53 reduces to an eight. This is the year of the eight. So for those of you Geminis who have not maybe, who have maybe not have been feeling like yourself, have been not maybe believing in yourself. This is giving me magician vibes, like in the tarot, which is also a magician slash Virgo card, okay? So for me, as a reader, this is like showing up in your own energy, starting off right off the bat, okay? So for some of you, whatever, this could also be to do with your, the way you make money, okay? Some of you could be manifesting, let's say, a new career, a new job. For those of you that maybe have wanted to get hired at a certain place, but maybe it's really hard to get in, and some of you have maybe have been blocked in some type of way, or just it feels like whatever intentions you've been putting out to the universe, or for those of you that do you know, work with the elements and do magic and things like that, some of you maybe haven't been getting the results that you've been wanting, okay? So it's like if you've been feeling, for those of you that have been feeling like, you know, kind of like not really believing in yourself, spirit is restoring your belief in yourself. For some of you, it's literally opening up new doors of opportunity that maybe kind of show you and remind you how powerful you really are. Some of you have been maybe kind of like sleeping on yourself, I'm hearing, in some type of way. And that's not always our fault, right? It's like when the 3D isn't reflecting back to you, essentially what you've asked for, sometimes it can make it difficult to, you know, really know that I'm doing the right thing or what I'm doing is working. And that's where the blind faith kind of comes in, is where you have to just trust that, you know, like the same way we do Amazon. I love using that analogy because it's just so fitting when I talk about these kind of things. So it's the same thing as that, even when you're at a restaurant, right? When you put in your order, you're putting in the trust that the waitress is gonna get it right, that the chef isn't gonna fuck up, and you're gonna come and they're gonna come back with a meal that you're gonna really love and enjoy. And most times, right, 9 times out of 10, that's what happens. And then so that same thing like with Amazon, right? We decide what we want to order. We pay for the order, right? By our putting us same things we put in our request out into the universe. and we patiently wait for that package to be delivered to our house, which is the same thing as, you know, waiting for the universe to work its, kind of do its part, right, on our behalf to bring in whatever we're manifesting. So I feel like where some of you have been kind of like I said, not believing in yourself, kind of sleeping on yourself, not maybe doubting your manifesting abilities, spirit is restoring your belief in yourself at this time, okay? So that's a beautiful thing, all right? So clarifying that energy, we have the King of Pentacles, okay? And the Eight of Wands. So for some of you, this is some really good news that is coming in. For others of you, this could also be just, you know, kind of like, especially when in regards to stability, like I said, for some of you, maybe moving. Okay, some of you maybe have put in for a home, maybe done some magic to get a new home, or done like, you know, paid for, whether you paid someone to do it or you did it yourself, it doesn't matter. They're all just tools, right? So some of you are hearing back about that, where some of you Geminis are about to move. Some of you, you could be moving for work, okay? Some of you have been maybe, let's say, wanting to move countries, and you applied for a job in another country that you want to move to, and this is like hearing back them saying you're approved, we're going to pay for your visa, and you know, you get to, we need you here in you know, 2 weeks, like type thing, okay? Some of you, this could be exactly what this is that you get the job, or you get the home, you get approved for the home. Some of you are signing, I'm hearing signing the lease for like a, whether it's a contract, like an independent contract, something like that, contractor. Others of you, this is like your own home or your own apartment, whatever that is. And it's like the process is going really fast. Like you're maybe getting approved faster than you thought. Maybe you're hearing back from this job interview faster than you thought. It's like something is speeding up. Something is going way faster than you were expecting it to go, okay? And that's where I feel like for some of you in itself is restoring your faith in yourself, your belief in your own powers of manifestation, your own power of, you know, really, you know, being reflected back to you of how powerful you are, your power of intention, your, you know, how powerful your words are, and being mindful of what you say because it does return to you, right? So for some of you, this is like your evidence in showing you that it's like whatever you're seeing is like, holy shit, I did manifest that. Okay, maybe I am that powerful. Maybe I am really, you know, doing this thing. Maybe I am, you know, really co-creating with spirit my own, you know, reality, right? I just saw 808 on the timer. So some of you may be seeing 808. That might be a number of significance, okay? So clarifying that. See what I'm saying? The Wheel of Fortune, okay? The Wheel of fucking Fortune. This was divine timing. So some of you have been doubting yourself, but spirit is restoring it, okay? Where you guys have been doubting yourself, it's like it's all coming back, but it's because it's divine timing, okay? It just maybe wasn't time yet. It's like you have to, it's like different things. Like when you're cooking, it takes different dishes, different times to, you know, to be complete, to be cooked thoroughly, to be, you know, come out at a certain texture with a certain, you know, where all the flavors just perfectly mingle and infuse together. You see what I'm saying? So for some of you, you've been really doubting and questioning yourself, and it's like you're about to see why you don't need to do that. Okay, so for some of you, it feels like you're really landing a new job. Okay, some of you may be starting a new business and things are taking off really quickly. Maybe you're getting clients really, really fast, and it's because it's part of your destiny. This your destiny. For some of you, this is the way, or however this is playing out, is playing out exactly how it needed to. Okay, for others of you who have maybe kind of, like I said, been questioning things because of the timing, it just seems like something was taking forever. Well, it's all happening fast now because it's the right time. You're ready for it. Okay, some of you maybe just weren't ready for it and you didn't know that. So I would still, regardless, thank spirit. Because the Most High always knows when we're ready for something. So while we're trying to rush the process, not realizing, like, Spirit's waiting on purpose. And you'll see when it finally does show up that you're actually more ready for it when it shows up than you were when you thought you wanted it. Okay? So for some of you, you're going to see that for yourself. All right? So spiritually speaking, we have Hex Banishment came out sideways, which I thought was really interesting. When I saw that card land sideways, I had a feeling I knew what it was because I kind of saw a very slight glimpse of it, but I never turned it over. So I was like, I'm going to just leave it how it came out. I feel like it came out like that for a reason. And then sure enough, this came out upright, protection. Okay, so for some of you, that could be why some of you, that something you've been asking for, something you've been trying to manifest, it feels like it was taking a long time because it seems like someone in your energy, someone in your vicinity, someone who maybe doesn't like you, it could be a hater, it could be an ex, someone that maybe you stopped fucking with, whatever, okay? Someone was trying to block you, okay? And spirit protected you from that. Especially for those of you that obviously didn't do anything wrong. If you did something wrong, karma would have hit you. You see what I'm saying? This is also Wheel of Fortune also represents karma, which is this year. So it feels like, Gemini, you guys obviously have been putting out good energy because otherwise you wouldn't have been protected from it, okay? If somebody is sending something to you, if it's justified, it'll actually hit you. If you're vibrating on that frequency, it will hit you, right? But for those of you that obviously haven't been vibrating on that low-ass frequency is why you were protected from whatever this hex that someone maybe tried to put on you. But that's why I'm saying something wasn't the right time, okay? Because you were being protected from this first, okay? So I feel like some of you are really about to see that, you know, it's not me. This is your proof right here. I feel like for some of you as well, is that some of you have been questioning yourself, wondering why something hasn't happened. Why didn't I get approved? I'm you know, more than qualified, or I make more than enough money to get this apartment or this place or whatever the case is, right? Not knowing it was something else at play here. So this is your indication letting you know that you don't have to doubt yourself anymore. Spirit is showing you how you don't need to question your own abilities of manifestation, your own magical abilities in your own life. It was just something else, right? Was you were being protected from something. If they had given you what you asked for at that time, you would have probably been caught in the crossfire of whatever this is, right? But that's why Spirit had you wait. That was a part of your protection, okay? So I feel like for some of you who have been mad at Spirit, who've been trying to cuss the universe out about why this hasn't happened yet, what the fuck's going on, why is it taking so long, you may want to apologize. I'm just saying. Okay? You may want to apologize. You know, free will's the thing, do what you do, but I'm just saying, sometimes we, you know, that's the thing. And that's where I say blind trust and faith comes in, is because your spirit guides, your ancestors, whoever it is you know, talk to or you make requests to, they see things that we can't see. They hear conversations we're not hearing. They see and know people's intentions that we are completely unaware of, okay? So spirit is, you know, I feel like protecting you guys from something and you had no idea. Right? Sometimes, like when we were driving somewhere and we're so upset that, like, why is there so much traffic and blah, 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 or, you know, whatever, or why you get detoured to go the other way and not realizing it was saving you from an accident. What if a plane happened to crash right there? Or what if a train happened to flip over and take that whole row of cars out? You see what I'm saying? And you were being protected during that time. So it's just, you know, sometimes you just have to have faith in the unknown, that maybe that things are actually playing out for your benefit, even if you can't see that. Some of you haven't been able to see that, but this is your indication right here that you were really being protected from someone that was trying to throw shit at you, okay? Someone that was trying to hex you or keep something from coming to you, okay? So that's for somebody. All right, so clarifying the energy is the Five of Cups and the Seven of Cups. Yeah, this is for some of you, this is someone that you broke up with. This feels like someone that maybe you know, stopped fucking with, like I said, whether it's a friend, whether it's an ex, a spouse, whatever, it doesn't really matter. Okay, this could have been a job you left. Like, however that applies. Some of you left someone feeling really, really lonely, I'm hearing. Someone is really feeling like you left them out, basically. And so it feels like someone was also maybe jealous of all the attention. For some of you, so this is attention that you were getting. This could be different opportunities that were coming towards you, and they were like, they don't deserve that. Well, why am I not getting that? And they wanted to block you, thinking that that will help them. Someone is in mad regret. That's why you're protected, because someone's regretting trying to confuse you, trying to, like, you know, make you pick the wrong thing. That's why for some of you, that's what this indecision card is here. Okay, is that you had someone throwing, you know, maybe it did a confusion spell on you, or, you know, even if they're just saying stuff, people don't realize their words are literally casting spells. That's why it's called spelling. Okay, you don't have to always light a candle to do a spell. Someone saying, I hope you fucking die, I wish you get in a car accident, blah, blah, blah. That's casting a spell right there. Okay, so I feel like for some of you, that's what this is. Some of you, somebody is going to be in heavy regret over whatever confusion they try to, you know, put on you, for some of you, it's an illusion, okay? That someone cast it upon you, or, you know, making you think that you weren't powerful, or that what you were asking the universe for, making you feel like, because it's taken so long or it hadn't happened yet, that you weren't worthy of it. And the spirit, and one thing I've learned more recently, that spirit is never going to tell you no. Spirit is either going to say yes, not right now, or there's something better. That's it. Spirit, you always get what you want, whether it looks how you think it should look or not. That depends on your specificity, right? How specific you are on what you're asking for, right? If you just say, I want a cheeseburger, but you don't, and then it just comes to you literally a cheese on top of a burger with the bread, and that's it. And you're like, well, where's the lettuce? Where's the tomato? Well, you didn't ask for that. You just asked for a cheeseburger. That just shows you how specific, more specific you need to be, right? And we tend to get mad at ourselves or mad at the universe. Well, you know what I mean. I want a cheeseburger, supposed to come with all these things, right? That's not what you asked for, though. So some of you have been really in this energy of questioning yourself, questioning what it is you're asking for, because, you know, thinking that it's you, but really it was because you were being protected from someone trying to block you, trying to stop you, trying to, you know, make you pick the wrong thing, maybe pick the wrong career, pick the wrong, you know, opportunity, the wrong contract, whatever it is. It's like somebody was that's in your energy is trying to fuck with you, okay? And making you question yourself. So look, nine of cups, 7, 5, and the 9, all cups, okay? So for some of you, this is definitely love. Some of you have broke up with someone, or someone that you, like I said, stop fucking with, and they're mad about it. Someone's definitely feeling the loss of this connection, and that's why they're trying to block you from maybe talking to other people, from other suitors. But all that did was position you to get exactly what you want. With the 9 of cups here, spirit is restoring your happiness, your fulfillment, things that maybe you thought you lost. Spirit is restoring all that, and then some, okay? So I feel like some of you, like I said, have been confused. You've been maybe under an illusion, okay? But like I said, whoever tried to, you know, put a hex on you, tried to do that, block you in any kind of way, this is the energy they're in. They're going to feel that shit, because why? This is the year of the fucking 8. This is the year of karma, okay? Meaning what you reap, you will sow. Okay, what you sow, you shall reap. Meaning, whatever seeds you plant is what you're going to reap harvest from. And that's not good or bad, it's just what the fuck it is. Okay? All karma really does is designed to teach you things. So, based on whether it's good or bad, that's just the labels we choose to give it. We choose to give the experience. But again, this is karma. Okay? So, whoever this is, okay, someone's in regret. Someone is going to see, for some of you, you may be finding out exactly who this is. Okay? But others of you, it just feels like whatever options that some of you maybe thought you missed, thought that you got passed up on, it's like you're getting exactly what you wish for. You're getting exactly what you asked for. It's like you're all of what you feel like you lost, or you thought you lost. Like I said, with this illusionary energy, some of you, this has to do with, you know, options, opportunities that maybe you thought you lost. That's an illusion. And you're going to see that. You were just being protected, okay? And you're about to get exactly what you were wishing for, exactly what you wanted, you know, but it's like sometimes spirit has to remove things, though, to make room for what you're asking for. And that seems like that's what's happening here. Okay. So what spirit needs from you is, we have the tribe card number 8. Again, another, okay, 8 with 53 is the 8. Okay. With the 8 of wands. So that's 3 8s in itself. But with the 10, this is karma. So this is like, you know, still the 8 energy for me. So 888, some of you may be seeing 888, okay? So we have the tribe and why, card 31, okay? So I feel like some of you might benefit by talking to people that you know have your back, people that can help you, okay? I feel like some of you may be trying to figure out why things are happening, or why things are, you know, kind of like getting clear about why you're doing what you're doing, why you want the things that you want. And then you may find clarity in that by talking to people that you trust. Okay. I feel like some of you, you know, maybe whoever this is that try to throw this, you know, hex on you or whatever, try to block you in some type of way, is someone that maybe you thought you could trust, but you really can't. So some of you are being guided to go outside of that. And because your tribe is not always family, unfortunately. It's not always your bloodline, okay? Your tribe is people that are typically not of your kin, meaning they're people that you meet through experiences as you evolve on this journey, okay? And so they're typically not people that you're actually by blood DNA related to. So you might, for those of you who have people that you consider your tribe, you may reach out to them, you know, and ask them, you know, about why are you doing this, or why are you, you know, kind of like pick their brain about things, right? Get clarity through them. But I feel like for some of you as well, this is talking about being open to this type of your soul tribe coming to find you, right? And you do that by operating from a place of authenticity and genuineness and integrity, right? That's how you call in the people that are just like you, by operating in the most genuine, pure place that you possibly can. You attract in those same type of people that you can then build with and grow with and collaborate with from there, okay? So clarifying that, we have the Two of Swords and the King of Cups. So yeah, I feel like this has to do with, like I was saying, about getting clarity about something, okay? The Two of Swords is giving me this indecision energy here, but although on this card, it looks more like the Two of Wands, which is interesting because at the bottom of this tarot deck is the Two of Wands, okay? So 2-2-2 here, all right? Even though it's funny because this card is a number 8, but in the tarot it's 2. You see what I'm saying? There's something here with that. There is something here with that. 2, 4, 6. I don't know. That's weird though. That's interesting. Another 8. Okay. So, like I said, but yeah, I feel like some of you are, whatever you've been undecided about or kind of like confused, not sure which way to go or what you want to do, Spirit is saying get emotionally grounded, okay? Stabilize your emotions. Go within, okay? Maybe you might benefit by getting around some water to clear out, you know, purge would be very helpful, okay, for you to get clear about something. I feel like for those of you that are kind of like unsure about where you should go, you might check in with your tribe. For those of you that maybe can't seem to ground yourself emotionally to get clear within yourself, you might bounce some ideas off of people that you also trust that are around you, okay? Asking, you know, getting clarity from them. Why are you on this path? Why did you choose this? Or why, you know, whatever that is, pick their brain, like I said. Anything that you're confused about, anything that you maybe don't feel like you have all the information on, okay? Anything that you feel is being hidden from you. This is, you know, talking about that, okay? But doing it from a place of being grounded, being emotionally grounded, meaning you're not overreacting, you're not yelling, you're not being dramatic, or just calm, cool, and collected, right? So clarifying that is the Knight of Wands and the Seven of Pentacles. So this is, like I said, getting clear about why you're doing what you're doing. You know, why you're doing whatever it is that you're investing on, it's getting clear about why you're doing it, okay? That's like the best place to respond or take action from, is in being inspired by being, and you get inspired by being clear about your why, being clear about why you're doing something. Why am I investing? For those of you that are kind of like undecided about if I should move here or here, well, why do I want to move there? Why do I want to move here? If you, even the same thing when it, in regards to your work, right? Well, why do you want to start this business? Why do you want to start this business? Why do you want to do this project? Getting clear about your why will help you inspire you when it comes to investing, because for some of you, it's like something may be taking a long time, or you know something might take quite a bit of work. It may feel like something is slow and it's going to require your patience. And so that's why it's important for you to analyze, is this something that I'm willing to do? Is this going to grow the way I think it will? And that's how you get clear about, you know, whether or not you should take action on it, whether or not, are you even inspired? Does it inspire you? Why does it inspire you? Okay, I feel like some of you are really being asked to get clear about these things. Ask yourself these questions, which will also then help you decide what direction you want to go, or what it is that you want to invest in before you actually make the investment by getting clear. Why do I want to do this thing in the first place? Okay, so that way you don't find yourself wasting time. And if you can't answer those questions, then maybe that's something you don't need to pursue. It's really that simple, okay? So, your money, career, finances. We have parenthood, okay? Which says, spend more time with your inner child and reconnect with that young curiosity. Your patient, nurturing, what do we say? Patient, nurturing, warm nature can make you a great caregiver or parent. Don't forget to nurture and treat yourself while you work hard towards your goals, okay? So this is, don't leave yourself out while you're working hard and you're busting your ass for whatever you're doing for other people. Make sure you're taking the time for yourself too, okay? So then we have, next out is gift. And we did see exchanging gifts, okay? So some of you may be getting a gift from someone. For some of you, someone may be wanting to fix things. Someone may be trying to give you a gift to try to fix or mend a connection. Like I said, someone is in regret for what they've done to you. And I feel like it's because someone is going to see very soon, Gemini, that it didn't work. Whatever they're trying to block you in, whatever they're trying to confuse you and make you pick the wrong thing or whatever the fuck, you're still getting what you want, all right? Which is then leading you to a new life, okay? Because, and it's just because something wasn't for you, not for you, okay? Some of you, it's going to show you that this person, if this was a person, whether it's a friend, a spouse, it doesn't matter, they're not for you. Meaning they're not supposed to enjoy in this fortune or whatever this new life is that you're creating. Not everybody is meant to go with you. Not everybody is meant to enjoy in that new life with you, that new experience with you. So it feels like someone is trying to like then regenerate, you know, bring something back up from the dead in order to enjoy this treasure island and milk and honey, okay, that you're coming into, Gemini. So we have gift here. Someone might give you a gift, lend money, or help you in some type of way. I'll be mindful with that, all right? There could be, like I said, someone who is trying to confuse you or trying to all of a sudden come back around and be like, oh, let me help you, blah, blah, I could help you, da, 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 da. But it's just a way to get in to when you start winning, then they feel like they're entitled to do this and have their hand out for your rewards, right? So just something to be mindful of. You could get a cash bonus at work. You have natural talents, gifts, abilities just waiting to be discovered. Explore them. Didn't we talk about that earlier? When I said some of you might have gifts, okay, with this retail, that some of you might have gifts or something that you can give in exchange, you know what I'm saying, for money or whatever. That's what I was talking about with this exchanging gifts when I first started the reading, when I was reading the bottoms of the decks, okay? And then here we have gift, okay? So yeah, some of you, this is a confirmation that some of you, this is your for some of you, this kind of feels like an initiation, okay? Spirit is initiating you to, now it's time to tap into your gifts. You realize that you're gifted at something. You realize that you have some sort of natural talent or ability, something that you're really good at, that you can give to the world and also get compensated for it. This is your opportunity to step into that, to pursue that, okay? Some of you may have been confused about what that is. And that could be because you have other people. A lot of times people see your gift in you before you see it for yourself. And that for some of you is what this is that someone's trying to block you from knowing your gift, keeping you, trying to keep you confused about what my gifts are, what am I good at, because they knew that you would be something fucking amazing, okay? They knew that things would take off for you. They knew that things would go in a really positive direction for you very quickly. Somebody didn't want that, which is bogus. It is, but it's just, you know, we have to be real here. It's what the fuck it is. But that's teaching you. It's teaching you to take back your power and not let anybody ever derail you or knock you off your square ever again, right? So the last card, we have business. Do not be intimidated to enter the world of business. You got this. Consider executive positions, becoming a CEO, or anything in the corporate world. Elevate your awareness and think bigger if you want different results, okay? So like I said, this is what Spirit is restoring, is your ability, like I said, to believe in yourself. For some of you, that is what this career card here is talking about. And it's like coming full circle, right? We started off with this and we're ending with this. Career and business. So some of you, this is manifesting a brand new career, but in your own business, being your own CEO, being your own boss. Some of you have been maybe thinking about that, were confused about how to do it, okay? Maybe because of losses you've had in the past, and it made you feel like, I can't do it again, or I don't want to make that investment because, you know, I don't want that to happen again. It's like, it just wasn't, for some of you, it just wasn't the right time, but now is the right time. Divine timing is at play here. Whatever you're being guided to do, it's destined. It's destined to happen. It's destined to turn in your favor. But now it's like the wheel is turning for you. It's here for you. You need to hop on. It's kind of like the train. You've been waiting so long for your train to pull up. Train's finally pulled up. Are you going to get on or are you going to wait? And not knowing if that train is going to come back around again. You know what I'm saying? So let's clarify. Clarifying that energy is the Five of Swords, okay, with the King of Wands. So this is getting out of your mind. Don't let your mind manipulate you into not believing in yourself, to not taking action on whatever this is that you're being guided to do, Okay, some of you may be getting like randomly getting sponsored or something, and it's giving you like the jump start you need to start your business. Don't sleep on that. Somebody maybe randomly is being like, yo, you know, I know you talked about this before, and I have the money now to invest. You want an investor? Do you need an investor? And some of you may pass up on that opportunity. This is spirit saying, don't let your, you know, negative thinking manipulate you into not taking action on this, into not going for it. Okay, if that's something you're being guided to do, follow that. Okay, so clarifying that energy is, look, the Eight of Wands, okay, with the Four of Pentacles. So for some of you, this may be happening too fast, or some of you may hold back, okay, because this is an outcome. I mean, in your business section. So some of you may end up holding back from this. But what this also feels like is, if you start this business and you guys take action on it, okay, especially if it's something you're passionate about, it's going to take off really quickly, and it's going to accumulate more than enough money for you to save, because that's what the Four of Pentacles is. It's having stability, enough stability to actually have some to hold, meaning you have money to pay your bills and take care of business, but then you also have some to put aside as well. Okay, and for some of you, that's what spirit is restoring here. Some of you, this could be just coming in as good news, something that you've been waiting to hear about. Okay, whether this is a job or something you apply for, but others of you, this feels like something you're doing on your own. You're being guided to start your own business. And some of you, that's what you've been in limbo about, with the indecision. You've been kind of like, I don't know. Maybe I've tried it before. Maybe I've tried it before and I suffered a great loss. I don't know if I want to do that again. Okay, but spirit is saying, back then though, it wasn't the right time. Now is the right time. What did you learn from that you can take into this new experience? Because when you start over, you're not starting over from scratch. You're starting over from experience. So it feels like some of you, if you go ahead and take this, you know, jump into this and take this risk, right, to invest in something that you know you're passionate about, okay, even if you maybe can't see exactly what's ahead, right, but you trusting that it's going to take off and it's going to yield more than enough money to actually be able to save and put some aside and have some to invest and put in other things you want as well, okay? Because like, look, coming out at the beginning, King of Pentacles. Okay, so it's like spirit is restoring your stability. So those of you that have been maybe, like I said, struggling financially, that's changing, okay? And that was the Eight of Wands that came out that first time too. And the Eight of Wands, again, another full circle thing, right? We start off with this, the career, end it with the business. Start off with Eight of Wands and literally ending with the Eight of Wands, okay? So it's kind of like, what you gonna do, Gemini? What you gonna do, okay? So I feel like some of you, like I said, if you've been confused about something, it was because somebody was trying to make you, you know, fuck with your mentality. Some of you, this could have been by way of manipulation and you didn't even know about it, okay? Some of you, this could have been a business partner or someone that was, you know, fucking with your mind, making you question yourself because they, you know, were jealous of the opportunities. It was like they were close enough to see what was possible, but they weren't close enough to actually be a part of it or actually reap the benefits of it. So what is the most they could do, right? Is confuse you, make you get confused and be undecided about what you should invest in, what you should actually go for, right? So I feel like some of you are really about to see very, very soon that you were on point the whole time, okay? So if anything had been taking its time, it's because it was protecting you from something, okay? So like I said, if you've been upset at spirit and yelling at the universe, I probably apologize. Just, you know, suggestion, okay? Do what you want. But Gemini, that's what I have for you. I really hope you enjoyed this reading. If you did, I really appreciate if you smash that like, that thumbs up. Consider subscribing if you have not. And until next time, you guys, happy.